Circus Arts Conservatory. Welcome to CAC Connects. Today, I have some circus posters to share with you. We'll talk a little bit about the history of them, what's on them, and why, and making our own. Circus posters were used as advertisements to draw large crowds to places where circuses would perform in just one or two cities.
This Barnum & Bailey poster advertises a circus parade that will be right before their circus show. You can see that it gives the time and the cost and describes the show.
As advertisements, circus posters were designed to be eye-catching. They use big, bold colors, especially red. Circus posters started being in color, especially using red, in the 20th century. The reason for this was to stand up to the weather, for example, the sun or the rain. This poster shows us an example.
Here you can see the bold colors and drawings that were made to stand up to the weather elements. You can see lots of red being used, although it is not the color of the writing itself.
Also importantly, circus posters are descriptive. But what's that mean? It means they use descriptive words or adjectives to describe what you might see when you go see the circus. For example, they use sizes or colors or how fantastic something might be when you go see it. They describe the complex tricks of the acrobats and animals and shenanigans that you'll see the clowns do in the circus that it's advertising.
Posters such as this one illustrate and describe what the artist would like to show you. You can see the man doing the twisting somersault. It's described on the poster as a marvelous mid-air pirouette or twisting double somersault. One thing I personally find most interesting about this poster is the catcher's position. In their descriptive language, circus posters often used alliteration and exaggeration. This feat looks like it doesn't need to be exaggerated, in my opinion, because it looks pretty fantastic. It reads, "Parisian in a dreadful headlong leap, loop and topsy-turvy plunging somersault with an automobile, an absolutely unparalleled deed of daring, just as illustrated and costing nearly $2,000 a minute, the most expensive, as well as the most hazardous act ever devised." Alliteration and exaggeration, like I just mentioned, can be used on posters to describe things, such as the acrobats in the middle of the poster. You could describe these acrobats as the fabulously fantastic flippers, rather than just acrobats. And that would be alliteration, because if you notice, fabulously, fantastic, and flippers all start with the letter F. That's how alliteration works. The first letter of each word is the same. You could exaggerate something in this poster by saying, for example, the man on the bottom right is the largest man in the world. It's likely that he isn't, but it's a liberty that posters often take.
Now that we've learned a bit about circus posters, let's make our own. To do this, you'll need some art supplies, such as paper, colored pencils, markers, and a pencil. It's also a great idea to have a separate piece of paper for brainstorming. Things that you can brainstorm would be the name of your circus, what cool feats you'll describe on your poster, and then some ways to describe them. It's a good idea to write down extra descriptive words. For example, instead of big, huge, or ginormous, or massive. And then start your circus poster. I started mine with putting the name on, and then the drawings of the things that I would like to advertise, and then I explained them down at the bottom. Here's mine. It says, "Watch as talented, dedicated young performers dazzle you with their strength, grace, and bravery on the ground and in the air." And this is what it looks like. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you make your own. If you enjoyed this lesson and would like to see some more on circus posters, you can also check out The Ringling online. Thanks for watching. Keep calm and circus on.